Hi everybody, welcome back to our channel Respect Education. We have seen earlier the solutions of AP PolySet 2020 Mathematics 1 to 60 questions. Now in this session we are going to solve the questions from 61 to 90, that is from physics. Now without wasting much time, so we enter the question number 61. The work done by an electric force in moving a unit positive charge from one point to another point in a circuit is called dash. See here, there is a point A to B. Here, the work done by electric force in moving a unit positive charge from point A to point B is called potential difference. So here other options are also there, children. First one, resistivity. Resistivity is the nature of a metal. And drift speed, it indicates the speed of the electrons. Whereas conductivity, this is also nature of a metal. Especially if it allows electricity to pass through it, then we can call it as conductor, and the nature is called conductivity. So here for this question, the option second one is the right option for question number 61. Now let us see next question, that is question number 62. Two currents 0.5 milliamp and 5 milliamp flow towards the junction circuit, and three currents 1 milliamp x and 2 milliamp flow away from the junction. Then the value of x in milliamps is, see, let us take this as a junction. Here two currents, they enter. See, this arrow mark indicates entering. They enter towards the junction. The values are given as, it is 0.5 milliamp and this is 5 milliamp. And then three currents, those are 1 milliamp and x and 2 milliamp. 1 milliamp, x and 2 milliamp, they are moving or they are going away from the junction. So here we need to find the value of x in milliamps. Actually this problem, it depends on Kirchhoff's junction law. It states that the algebraic sum of the currents entering the junction is equal to the algebraic sum of the currents leaving the junction. So here the sum of the currents entering the junction, those are 0.5 plus 5 is equal to the sum of the currents leaving. So here 1 is leaving, x is leaving, 2 is also leaving. So here 0.5 plus 5 gives us 5.5 equal to 1 plus 2 is 3 plus x. Let us send this 3 this side. So here finally x is equal to 5.5 minus 3. So x is equal to 2.5. So here the current is in milliamp. So x is also in milliamp. Now let us see the options here, children. From the options, option 2 is the right one for the question 62nd one. Now let us see next question, that is question number 63. The magnetic force acting on a moving charge is given by the product of three quantities, namely, actually here we have a formula, children, that is force depends on three quantities, product of three quantities, those are Q into V into B. Here Q is for charge, V refers here speed, and B is magnetic flux density. So here from the options, you see option 3, charge, speed, magnetic flux density. So for the 63rd one, option 3 is correct. Now let us see next question, that is question number 64. Lenz's law gives, here four options are given. Before going to the four options, let us recall what is that Lenz's law. The induced current will appear in such a direction that it opposes the changes in the flux in the coil. So here finally let us see now the options what are given. First one, direction of the magnetic field line at any point. Second one, magnetic force acting on a current carrying wire in a magnetic field, direction of induced current, pole strength or bar magnet. If you observe here, see lens like gives induced current and direction. So it gives finally the direction of induced current. So for the 64th question, option 3 is right one. Now let us see next question, that is question number 65. An auto driver has started his auto with the help of a rope by pulling. The device used by him to convert mechanical energy to electrical energy is dash. Let us see the options here. First one, battery. Actually, battery converts chemical energy to electrical energy. So battery is not the right option because we need mechanical energy to electrical energy. So second one, you see transformer. Transformer is a device which transfers electricity. So that cannot be the option. And third one, fuse. Fuse is a small device where it can be used if the current had been overflown, means excess current passes through it, then immediately it itself melts to save the appliance. So that cannot be the option. Now finally, fourth one, you see dynamo. Dynamo is the right option that converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. So for the question 65, option 4 is the right one. Now let us see next question, that is question number 66. The material more suitable for the core of electromagnet is. See, actually electromagnet, it has one core material. On that, copper wire is wounded with number of turns. So that setup is called solenoid. Now the question is that the material which is more suitable for the core. Actually, among the options, the more suitable one is soft iron. So that is the third option here. So for the 66th question, option 3 is the right one. Now let us see question number 67. A conductor moving with a speed of 20 meter per second. So speed, given speed is 20 meter per second. In the direction perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field of induction 0.5 t. So that is indicated by capital B, 0.5 t for Tesla. Induces an EMF of 5 volts. So EMF indicated by epsilon, that is 5 volts. Then the length of the conductor, that is L, is to be found. So now here, if you observe, we have a formula, children, that is epsilon is equal to B into L into V. Let us substitute the given values. Here epsilon equal to 5 is equal to, here B means 0.5, we can write as 5/10 into L, that is what we need to find, into V. V is 20. So now here this 10 will go 2 times in 20, so it is 5 2s are 10. So 5 is equal to 10 times L. Now here let us send this 10 this side, so L is equal to 5/10. So it is on cancellation 1/2. So it is 0.5. As length of the conductor is in meter, so option answer is 0.5 meter. Now let us see the option here. For this option, first one is 1 meter, second one 5 meter, third one 50 meter, fourth one 0.5 meter. So for the 67th one, option 4 is the right answer. Now let us see next question, that is question number 68. The magnetic field lines due to the horseshoe magnet between its poles are always straight lines. Here other options are given as squares, circles, loops of irregular shape. These all are not correct answers. So straight right option is option number 1, that is straight lines is the correct one. Now let us see next question, that is question number 69. A bar magnet is moved towards a coil slowly and then quickly. The induced EMF is, see actually here there is a coil and towards the coil a bar magnet is brought towards it. Okay, here is a coil. So here what happens, first in case A we have moved it slowly, in case B we have moved it quickly. So when we move slowly, then the induced EMF will be slow, or we can say smaller. So in case A, the induced EMF is smaller. In case B, it is larger. Induced EMF is smaller in case A, larger in case B. Now here let us see which options are suitable. First one, same in both the cases. Clearly this is not in same both the cases, so first option is not correct one. Large in case A, actually small in case A, that's why this option 2 is also wrong. Large in case B, see large in case B, this option 3 is right. Let us see fourth option also. Dependent only on the radius of the coil, that is also wrong option. So here for 69th question, option 3 is the right one. Now we see next question, that is question number 70. Which among the following pair of units measure the temperature? Actually here two pairs are given, means a pair is given in every option. We need to say which pair is suitable for temperature. First one, let us say degree Celsius and joule. Degree Celsius is temperature, right? But joule is for work, so that pair is not suitable. Second one is degree Celsius and calorie. Degree Celsius is for temperature, but calorie is for energy, so this is not the right option. Third one, degree Celsius and Kelvin. Absolutely these two are units of temperature only. Let us see fourth one, Kelvin and joule, same temperature and work. So here among these, this for the 70th question, degree Celsius and Kelvin, so option 3 is the right option.